As we explore quantum body, the new science of living a longer, healthier, and more vital life with Jack Tuzinski, the quantum biologist, quantum physicist, professor, and Brian Fertig, neuroendocrinologist like myself. And as we begin to see the similarities with some of the non-dual Eastern traditions, the question always comes up, are we inside the body or are we outside the body? Are we non-local? So this is a very good question, especially these days when everybody is exploring so-called out-of-body experiences, when we can't even explain the in-body experience. There's no little Deepak somewhere here looking at the world through these eyes. Whatever is looking at the world through these eyes is also looking at this body and looking at other bodies and also observing the mind. So you are where your awareness is. If your awareness is on your thoughts, then that's where you are. If your awareness is in your toes, that's where you are. If your awareness is in your bodily sensations, that's where you are. If your awareness is out here looking at this and all this, that's where you are. That is called non-local consciousness. And it is called Brahman. It is the ultimate reality, the absolute consciousness that underlies and pervades everything in the universe. And you are that as Atman. Brahman is not limited to any particular form or location, but is rather infinite and omnipresent. Our individual consciousness, the ego self, is considered to be a reflection of Brahman. It is limited and contracted form of consciousness that is identifying with the body-mind complex. While the ego self may experience itself as separate from others and from the world, this is ultimately an illusion. At the deepest level, we are all one, inseparably one. Not even interconnected, even though that's not a bad word. Thich Nhat Hanh said we are inter-beings that inter-arise in the inter-isness. When we say that non-local consciousness alone is the subject of experience, we mean that the ego self is not the true subject of experience. Rather, it is a witness to the experience of consciousness. The ego self may be involved in interpretation and evaluation of our experiences, but it is not the source of those experiences themselves. The body-mind complex is also considered, in this instance, to be an object of experience. It is a product of consciousness, but it is not consciousness itself. The body-mind complex is also constantly changing, evolving, but consciousness remains unchanged and eternal. When we realize that non-local consciousness is the true subject of experience, we are liberated from the limitations of the ego self. We begin to see the world as it truly is, a manifestation of pure consciousness. We also experience a deep sense of unity and inseparability, and almost, I would say, infinite love. Here's an analogy to help you illustrate this concept. Imagine that you're watching a movie. The movie screen is like the body-mind complex. It is the object of your experience. The projector is like consciousness. It is the source of the light that projects the images on the screen. The ego self is like the person sitting in the audience. It is the witness to the experience of watching the movie. The ego self may be involved in the interpretation and evaluation of the movie, but it is not the source of the movie itself. And just as the movie screen and the projector are both necessary for the experience of watching the movie, the body-mind complex and consciousness are both necessary for the experience of living. However, the ego self is not essential for this experience. It is simply a witness to the experience, just like the person sitting in the audience is a witness to the experience of watching the movie. When we realize that consciousness is the true subject of experience, we are liberated from the limitations of the ego self. We are able to experience the world as it truly is, a manifestation of pure consciousness. In one word, the body mind and its correlated world appearance are not the subject of experience. Non-localized formless awareness is the only subject of experience in every moment. And so even this screen that you're watching and you're listening to me right now, this experience is being processed not in the brain, but outsourced beyond space-time and processed beyond space-time. The brain itself is an experience processed outside of space and time. The in-body experience is part of our hallucination. When a person dies, the soul doesn't leave the body. The body experience disappears. Actually, out of body is the only subject of experience, because when it's out of body, non-local, it can localize itself anywhere. This is a deeper understanding of quantum entanglement. So let me know your thoughts.